Hello everyone. Today we have with us Noam. He is an experienced data analyst currently working in DB Test Technologies. He has a strong academic background with a bachelor's in statistics and a master's in big data. He's also interned at TCS and worked at Davik Earth as a data analyst. And he's also currently working at DB Test Technologies as a data analyst. This is a quick intro about you, sir. Can you define yourself? Like, how did it all start for you as a data analyst?
Actually, I'll have to go back to my bachelor days when I was doing my bachelor's. So yeah, it's really good in Karnataka where you can major in three different subjects. So I did my bachelor's in statistics, mathematics, and computer science. Looking back at now, it's just what data analytics is comprised of, actually. Yeah, so. As I was doing my bachelor's, yeah, I didn't feel like I wanted to just do my master's in one particular subject as such, because all three were interesting and I wanted something that is more application based. So I talked to a lot of people, my teachers, did some research on the internet, and I found out, okay, there is a course that is trending, big data analytics, and it's the next big thing, it's all about. So I thought, okay, yeah. Why not try it out? Because it looks like something that I really want to do. So yeah, so after I was done with my bachelor's, I did my master's in big data analytics in St. Joseph's College in Bangalore. And then from then, during my bachelor's, I did my internship at TCS. And then after my internship, I started my career at Davik Earth. For one year, 2 months, and now recently I joined DB Test Technology, and yeah, it's been 1 month there as well.
Wow! And your academic background is the right mix for a data analyst, like the most important things of statistics, computer science, and mathematics. So
yes,
your experience in big data analytics. So there are various different roles in data analytics, right? Because the data science hype is all over. So for the viewers, can you differentiate the different roles in an industry like data analyst, data scientist, or a big data, which is data engineering? Can you differentiate the different roles in the industry?
Yes. So I'll go the whole process at first. Okay. So now you know data is collected everywhere. Like, okay, even this data is itself collected a video recording, be it internet, be it social media, and data just collected from various sources. So when you're talking about any company or any organization as such, when data is collected, it's all collected from different sources and all messed up. So that is first where data needs to be arranged as such. Like, okay, I'm just putting in layman terms, okay, needs to be arranged, needs to be put out in a certain way. And that process is that is where the data engineer comes in. Okay, that's where the data engineer's job is to collect this data and they store it in technical terms as data warehouse. And that data warehouse is where all the data is collected and kept into a set of different data sets and different structures, and all these structures are interrelated to each other. And it's the job of the data engineer to map these structures out, to relate these data sets to each other, and keep it ready on a plate for a data analyst. Okay, and then once the data is structured and ready, the data analyst then analyzes this data, does different methods, statistical methods, could be any machine learning or anything, and gets the results out and displays it to whoever it is needed to. And when talking about data scientist is an all-rounder, yeah? Yeah, so right now, according to my opinion, the word data scientist is overly used. But from what I actually see it as, data scientist is a person who has tons of experience in the field of data science and who can do every job, be it data engineering, be it data analyzing, be it data visualization, each and everything. That is what a data scientist is.
I've heard this quote of data scientist is not a person, it's a team. So it's a collection of various different roles, people with different roles. That's what an all-round data scientist means. Yeah. So
yes, that's true.
So moving
on. So that's true. So when you talk about a team, you'll have people who are data. Even if you consider data engineering, it's not just one person working. It's a team that is doing the whole thing. And when it comes to analyzing, also as a team. So you can call it a data scientist as a team. But also, there are individuals who can do the same thing as well.
Yeah, true. So moving on to the next question. You interned at an MNC, like Tata Consultancy Service. And then you went on to work at an exciting startup, DeviCert. What's the difference between working in a MNC and in a startup? Because like a lot of students, they go behind brands, like the fan companies. But in startup, you get an exponential learning, right? So can you say the difference between working in a startup and in an MNC?
Yeah, so the MNC and startup both have their pros and cons. Okay, yeah. And I'm just blessed to be here, to be in both sides of it to tell the difference. Yeah, so, okay, we'll go with the MNC. So when I worked at a MNC, yes, you get a lot of exposure, but not as much as one would get at a startup. But at an MNC, you'll even get to learn from experienced people as well, be organized, and give you what to do. But yes, compared to a startup, the learning curve is much less. But for me, in a startup where I went, I was the only person in my department. Like I was the only data analyst. I was the only person in the whole data department. So that is where the learning curve went really high for me, because I basically had to do everything, and that is where I grew up a lot.
So you learned how to be organized in an MNC where already everything was sorted out. In a startup, you started it, you did everything, and you were the only person over there. So you had to learn everything by yourself by doing it.
Yes, exactly.
So can you brief us about your work at DeviCert? Because we at DAV focus on using analytics and data science for United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And we know that your work at DeviCert also resonates towards the UN SDG goals. So can you brief us about the work you're doing at DeviCert in your previous job role?
Yeah, so let me give a brief introduction about DeviCert. So DeviCert is a green tech company where they produce a technology called Pure Skies. So basically this device reduces air pollution in a very unique way. Okay, that technology is actually marvelous. It uses waves that of like the Wi-Fi, the same as same wavelength as that of the Wi-Fi. It uses these kind of waves to reduce pollution, and yeah, it is one of its kind, and it's really good. So the role that I play is, so when these devices are deployed at different places, the air quality data is collected, and for a proof of concept to show the people that, okay, the data is actually it is true, the pollution actually reduces. I collect the air quality data before the device has been switched on and after the device has been switched on. And I compare the air quality for a brief period of time, say 1 week before and 1 week after, and I show the results. Okay, how much percent the pollution has come down by. So it's basic statistics that I use, and visualization. Yeah, so mainly it comes out to visualization, because people just don't like to hear the numbers. They like to see the numbers. So that's where that comes in.
Yeah. So what are the different tech stack that you use? Like what are the different skills, or what to say, like the tech stack softwares which you use during your everyday job role?
So mainly I relied on coding everything in Python. So since I come from statistics as well as computer background, I love programming, I love coding as well. So I prefer to any kind of work. My first preference is actually to do it on Python, where I can write a program and execute it easily. So I wrote a whole program itself which would take in the data, do the analysis, and display the graphs as well, all in just one software and in one program.
I tend to know that statisticians, they, go towards R over, prefer R over Python. Can you tell me the difference between using R language and Python language? Because you're you have experience in both, so you would be in a better position to answer that.
Yeah, actually, it's mainly about comfort, actually, which and more of what one prefers. Okay, but yeah, people generally do go towards R because R is simple, easy to use. You have just one command for everything, and more user friendly for people who don't have programming experience. So personally, I prefer to use Python because there I can do whatever I want to do. Yeah, so both have their pros and cons as well.
True. Okay, we have talked a lot about programming and all those skills, but statistics is the unsung hero behind data analytics or machine learning or any other domain. So I would like to share a meme on statistics. One second. So just tell me your thoughts on it. Can you see the screen?
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah. So what's your thoughts on it? Because statistics has been around for more than decades, but right now, a slightly improved, advanced variation of statistics is what we call machine learning, artificial intelligence, and the buzz and hype is around a lot. So what's your opinion on it?
Actually, this thing is kind of true. Because like if you actually look at the definition of machine learning, artificial intelligence, machine learning is basically taking the old data and predicting what's the new data. And that part is just one segment of statistics. It's just one segment of statistics. People who do their bachelor's in statistics have it for one semester, I guess. And basically, if you're talking about statistics is answering any question using data. Right? So statistics is the basic fundamental of it. And over the course of my career, like I've talked to a lot of people who have been very experienced, and a lot of people have told me, like people who have worked 20 to 30 years in the industry, they have basically told me this: we have been doing the same thing since the 1990s. And right now people have coined the same term as data science, machine learning, artificial intelligence. But long back we used to just do the exact same thing as well, but we never got recognized for it. But it's a good thing now that it's getting a lot of recognition, it's getting a lot of importance as well.
So one second, I'll just stop sharing the screen. So yeah, getting on to my next question. Like you did a master's in big data. So how important is a master's to do a master's to get into a analytics role? Is it enough? Is the bachelor's enough, or is a master's necessary because you need the experience?
Actually, that's a bit of a hard question, really. Yeah, I was fortunate to do my master's in big data analytics. So it gave a kind of assurance. So when I went out seeking for a job, people like, okay, this guy did his master's in big data analytics. He knows what he's doing, right? So that kind of thing, okay, this guy is did his master's in big data analytics. He has that kind of title, yeah. So yeah, mainly, but this is my personal opinion. If a person knows what he's doing, because anybody can learn data science online, right? If you have a good internet connection, if you have a good system, you can do it by yourself and all that. And you can be good at it if you have the interest. But yeah, having the kind of masters, having the kind of degrees, just to assure people, okay, I know what I'm doing.
At the end of the day, it's skills and how we do it and not the degree in the paper. Yeah. So we can get all the theory knowledge from online courses and different sources in the internet. But practical applying it on real world data. Students need to do internships, right? Before getting into a job role, because even you did an internship during your academic period. So how important internships are that to get exposed to real world experiences of
So when coming to the field of data science, data analytics, big data, be it anything, internship is a must. Like I feel it is a must because people need exposure. Like, see, if you're doing a online course or if you're going to a college or university and getting that degree, yeah, but what I know, all colleges who are giving this course have internship and make internship compulsory. Because see, there's one thing, learning in theory or also experimenting data sets on Kaggle and other websites as well, or compared to working on real world problems. Because when you go to an industry, you're actually getting the problem, you're actually getting the struggles, you know what it is like going through it. So internship is a must, because that is where a student who's learning out will learn. And to be honest, actually, my learning came through my internship, came through my career. I learned much more through my internship and through my work compared to while I was studying big data analytics.
Yeah, the best way to learn is not studying, but doing it practically. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, because what you study, you may or may not remember, but what you experience, you'll always remember.
So we have come to the end of our talk show. It was a privilege for me to host you in this show. I think all the data analytics aspirants and also the data science aspirants would find this session very insightful. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for sparing your time and coming to our show.
Thank you. It's a pleasure being here as well.
Yeah, and one more thing. Noam was the representative from Devik Earth in Indo Data Week 2019. This year, Indo Data Week 2020 is going to be conducted from November 16 by DAV Data Solution. So, in case if you're interested, we will drop the link in the description. So, do register for it. We have a lot of surprises in it for all the data analytics aspirants. Stay tuned for more videos. Follow DAV Data Solution in their social media handles. Thank you. Thank you, Noam. See you soon.
Thank you, Sanjay. Yeah, see you.